Hi there, I'm Dr. Warren Wiechmann at the UC Irvine School of Medicine. We're going to talk a little bit today about some of these new technologies that are out there and changing the way that we both teach medical students and potentially going to practice medical care. One of the things that's really interesting, if you think about all these kind of portable technologies that we use as physicians, they really haven't changed much in the past couple hundred years or so. That's all changing though. So we're going to kind of go through some of these devices today, and I have the assistance of Dr. Alisa Wray, who also helps teach and work with these technologies here. So one of the easiest ones to think about here is this device. It's an otoscope. This is what we use to look in a person's ear. And what's different about this is it leverages this device that goes right through the camera and shows up on the screen so we can actually look at and share the images that we're taking a look at here. And this is actually available for about $80. It's available for both physicians, students, and patients, and these can be purchased to use with any sort of smartphone. The next device works very similarly, and it's what we call a dermatoscope. And so it takes a look at skin lesions up close, gives you a nice clean image of that mole. And we can kind of zoom it in, and with a pretty good analysis, kind of compare this over time. And the thought is, as a patient, to have access to this device, which is about a couple hundred dollars, and over time track sort of moles or lesions that you're concerned with. So this is an ophthalmoscope designed to look at the back of the eye. And this device is a little bit more expensive than the other ones for about $300 or $400 because of the special optics it has, but it really could allow that what's typically in a clinic to be attached to a smartphone. So this is actually a portable single lead EKG device. This one runs for about $100 or so, and it allows you to get a single lead EKG, and then after it finds a good waveform, you actually get a pretty nice image here of her heart rate and rhythm. So this is a digital stethoscope, and so like a traditional stethoscope, it works the same way, but it has this device here that takes the audio sounds and pushes them to a smartphone. And so I can listen in traditionally here, but I can also see the waveform of the breath and heart sounds show up here on my device. And so this little device here does full vital signs. It's about the size of a hockey puck and actually gives us the same degree of vital signs that we can get in an intensive care setting or an inpatient ward. We get blood pressure, we get heart rate, we get oxygen saturation, as well as temperature. So it's really interesting when you look at this in all these devices that you have within the kind of a small stand right here, you really have the same amount of almost diagnostic capabilities or accuracy that a standard clinic does, all of which could fit in sort of a little bag and around the price point of $1,000. When we look at all these interesting tools that are coming out there, it really allows us to figure out how to best incorporate them into how we teach our students to interact with patients and to learn clinical skills. So a lot of these devices, as you saw, have good capabilities for education, but could also fundamentally change the way that they practice. And so our goal is to put this into the curriculum early so these students have exposure to kind of what's currently out there and what's going to be coming out there in the future.